Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Funky Uncle Live tonight here from Tipitinas. That's right. I said we're here at Tipitinas. You know, here at Funky Uncle, we have been saying that we're going to bring the music to you until you can come to us. And you can do that. You've got plenty of time to get here and enjoy some fantastic music. What's the Funky Uncle, you might? If you just stumbled upon us, I want to tell you a little bit about what went down. Back in April of 2020, just a few weeks after the pandemic started, a group of folks got together and decided we've got to figure out a way to help our musicians and our gig workers. So let's find donations, let's give them musicians a gig to play, let's hire some sound people and lights and cameras and stagehands, and let's put on a show, and let's do that. And what we have now done for 104 weeks. Isn't that incredible? 104 weeks we've been doing this. And absolutely amazing. You, the viewers and the donors, have helped us to raise over $640,000. And $640,000 has gone right back out into our music community. It's taken us 2 years to get to where we are now, and we are so happy to be able to have this incredible event here at Tipitinas tonight. We've got lots to talk about, how you can help us, how you can donate. It's never too late to donate. Across the bottom of your screen, you'll see where you can text FUNK to 36413, or go to the website while you're watching. Check out FunkyUncle.Live. There's how to donate, how to become a sponsor, and also how to bid on the Frenchy Painting. Frenchy has given us a live event painting each and every week. We've got a few of those originals that are still for sale. We've got prints. We've got merch. We've got so many ways that you can help out your favorite musicians. Not to mention, get out and hear some live local music. That's what we do here. Tonight, it's been a couple of reschedules here for us, and we finally got these two characters. Yes, I just called you a character. We've got these, him. Oh, just him? Okay, one character and another good musician. All right, how about that? Tonight, we are so happy to be able to bring to you the incredible music of Mr. Marc Stone and John Mooney. Don't forget, wash your hands and stomp your feet.
Yeah. Right. Good evening, everybody. How's everybody doing? All right, I hope. I'm John Mooney. This is Marc Stone. And baby, please don't go. Baby, please don't go. Baby, please don't go back down to New Orleans. I love you so. Baby, please don't go. They got your man down here. Got your man down here. Got your man down here on the county farm. The shackles on. Baby, please don't go. For to be your dog. For to be your dog. For to be your dog. I'll get you way down here. Turn your lamp down low. Turn your lamp down low, baby, all night long. To please don't go, baby, please don't go. Thank you. turn your lamp down low. Turn your lamp down low. Turn your lamp down low. Baby, all night long. Thank you very much, Eddie. Thank you. city backwater blues made me pack my things and go. Them backwater blues made me pack my things and go. Well, a house washed away, can't live here no more. Thank you very much. Thank you. That's dedicated to all the people that suffered from the tornadoes that we had last night. And hope everybody is going to be all right by it. It's going to take a while, but that's that. So where are you going?
Good question. Good question. I got one for us. How about a little train kind of related? What you think of John Mooney, y'all? Now, I know you guys are being polite because we're filming, but what you think of John Mooney, really?
Well, thank y'all very much.
All right, right before the all the chaos ensued 2 years ago this month, I just put out an album called Live at Tipitina's. I recorded on a solo show here opening for the Rads. The song I started the album off with is a little Bob Dylan tune. You know I ride on a mail train. I can't buy a thrill. I've been up all night and now I'm leaning on my windowsill. But if I die on top of the hill, if I don't make it, yeah, you know my baby will. Now don't the moon look good when it's shining down through the trees? And don't that bright man look good now when it's flying down that double E? Girl, look fine, oh, running right here after me, Mr. Mooney. Has come, my window filled with frost. I went to tell every get my point across. Said I just want to be your lover, I don't want to be your boss. So don't you say I never warned you when your train gets lost. Something by Bob Dylan. Mr. Moon Man, Mr. Moon Man.
How about E?
All right, we're going to go back to 1928. Some of that old school evil kind of shit. Oh, wait, can I say that? I know it's a webcast. Is anyone here offended? If you're offended online, raise your hand. I can't see you. All right, then it doesn't count. So we're going to go back to 1928 and do this great song by Willie Brown. You might remember Robert Johnson referenced in the song Crossroads. Ooh, playing the pretty strat, too. This one's called the M&O. That M&O. When I leave here now, you know I'll catch the M&O. I'm going way down south where, good Lord, I've never been before. Ocean, huh? And I believe I will. Well, I get me an ocean, and good Lord, believe I will. I'm gonna build me a mansion out on Decatur Hill. Shame of yourself. I said, oh, you dirty man, oh, be ashamed of yourself. Go around, swam back, God, you got pulling a woman by yourself. For John Mooney, I went to kill my baby till she lay down across my bed. She looked so ambitious, took back every word I said. Across my bed, I got evil one morning till she lay down across my bed. She looked so ambitious, took back every word I said. So I asked her how about it, and good Lord, she said, all right. She said, all right. Yeah. She ain't never show up at the shack last night. Yeah, the M&O Blues. I see you, Coach.
Indeed. I better hear more applause than that. Come on. Yeah. You are in front of live music. 2 years ago today, we did not think we would hear it for a long, long time. And the Funky Uncle took care of that. Like I said, in April of 2020, we started bringing this to you. We've been able to help so many. Let's see, where are we at? We are at 852 musicians and gig workers that the Funky Uncle has been helping. Exactly, 852, that's incredible. And it's not just musicians, it's gig workers, it is our bartenders, our barbacks, our sound engineers, our lighting, it's just really, really, really been an amazing thing to be a part of and to sit back and watch. We've been able to help some of our bars as well. Tipitinas has been a recipient, and we are so grateful for them to remember that and to bring us back. Next week, we've got the Rumble with Big Chief Joseph Boudreaux Jr. That one's going to be a good one. And then April the 6th, we are celebrating our second anniversary, April the 6th. We're going to be back over at the Howlin' Wolf for that one. But I got to tell you about this one. This is an all-star band featuring Leo Nocentelli, George Porter Jr., C.R. Groover, Tom Worrell, Mike Lemler, Josh Paxton, Jason Neville, and the Funky Uncle All-Stars are all going to perform to pay tribute to the music of the musicians on the Funky Uncle float. Professor Longhair, James Booker, The Meters, Dr. John, Alan Toussaint, George Porter. It's going to be an amazing show, and you don't want to miss it. And the biggest reason that you don't want to miss it is I'm giving y'all some news. This is, you're going to hear it here first. The weekly Funky Uncles are coming to an end. The weekly webcast, yeah. I know. We set out to do a job, and that job has been accomplished. There will always be, yeah, thank you. There will always be folks in need, and the Funky Uncle is not going far. We are going to have some amazing special events throughout the year, a couple of times a year, to be able to keep that funk fund full so that we can help you. We're not leaving you out in the cold. It's just our weekly shows are going to come to an end on our second anniversary. And that is why I'm telling you about it now, because you do not want to miss this. If you still want to help after that, you can. It's never too late to donate. But what I need you to do is I'm going to need you to get out and hear live music. Come to Tipitina's, go to the Howlin' Wolf, the Maple Leaf, Bufa's, all the places that supported the Funky Uncle during all of our shows. We've filmed live shows there at all of those places. So get out there, go and support. Support your musicians, support your gig workers, because without them, this whole music community would not work. Now, I'm going to get off the stage because I'm ready to hear more music. And music, we do have Mr. Marc Stone. I called you Mr., huh? Didn't I? You heard that, right? Mr. Marc Stone and Mr. John Mooney. Don't forget to wash your hands and stomp your feet.
Right. Thank you, Leslie. We appreciate that. Miss Leslie. This one goes out to Miss Julie. Well, now, baby, you send me on the honey you do. Ain't nobody in the whole world can thrill me like you do. Baby, you something else. Honey, you something else. You're the prettiest little thing I see. Something else. Now every time you kiss me, I'm shining all over myself. the itty bitty pretty little thing, you know. You are something else, baby, something else. Honey, you something else. Yeah, you the pretty little thing I see, something else. To drive me wild, honey, you're something else. Oh, honey, you're something else. You're the pretty little thing I see, something else. Someday she will be there, but you know try to treat her right, give her everything. Boy, come to find out she's talking another man. But you know, don't need a doggone thing. Yeah, you find tomorrow, it don't mean a doggone thing. Think about my news in my life, but you know, mean a doggone thing. Well, you find tomorrow, don't mean a doggone thing. Do appreciate that. We're going to throw the ball back over here to Mr. Marc Stone. See what he's cooking up here.
One more time for Mr. Mooney.
What you got? Let's go up to A.
Hey, Leslie, where are you? Are there any verbal restrictions on this? Oh, good. All right. I want to piss you off plenty. We're gonna do my theme song. John and I have never played this before, but I think he'll get the sentiment. We'll do it in A. I usually do it in B flat. Oh, let's do it in B flat. You can get up to B flat with that thing, huh?
It might be difficult, but.
Huh? All right, might be difficult. All right. All right, how many of y'all are happy that you're getting to come here to Tipitina's and catch one of the very last of these Funky Uncle weekly webcasts, huh? Amazing what they've done for the community. As a matter of fact, hold on. All y'all get off the bars and stuff. There's like less than 100 of you in here. This is an 800-seater club. Would you all come up where we can see your faces while we're doing this? Come on up and get with us so we feel like we're all here together. I know the bar is nice to lean against, but come on up where we can feel you. Yes, indeed.
Yeah, you're close.
It is a pleasure to get to do this. We're doing a big birthday celebration. My birthday is on Saturday. So, yes, indeed. Appreciate it. So glad to see you guys here. And if anyone feels like buying the Frenchy painting from tonight and giving it to me as a birthday present, I will hang it in a very proud place in my home. Because I am so honored that Frenchy is here to paint us tonight. I've known Frenchy since we both used to be on Jackson Square. That's right. He was doing his paintings. I was with Tuba Fats and Lady Linda, and we were out there doing the thing. So it's really such an honor. And to be here at Tipitina's to do this, it's all just amazing. So we'll do this one. You tell me, babe, life ain't fair. That may be true, but I don't care. See, there's one thing I learned. Running round and round. No matter how they do you, don't let the bullshit bring you down. They might take your money, slap that boot on your car. Do you like they do people, yeah, near and far? You gotta keep on moving, and don't you lose no round. Yeah, don't let the bullshit bring you down. If you know what I mean, say yeah. Thank you.
your best friend might be a liar. Smoke up all your green and set your house on fire. Might try to steal your lover. She might succeed. What kind of friends, baby, do you really need? See, even if they break your heart, don't let it drive you underground. No matter how they do you or how they try to screw you fine, even if your lover and your best friend start to monkey around, don't let it put you in that hole in the ground. And don't let the bullshit bring you down. If you know what I mean, let us know and make some noise. Yeah, you're right. All right, so John and I started doing playing duos together about, gotta be 6 years ago now, something like that.
16, 7 years ago. Yeah. It was a while ago. It was. Before pre-pandemic days.
Pre-pandemia. You
know. Pre-tornado days, back in the hurricane days. And Chris, you can turn this vocal mic up in the monitor a little bit, please.
And speaking of tornadoes and stuff, here's a little sing-along song. Hey. We're going to do something we've never done in all the years we've played together. We've really barely ever done something with both of us playing slide guitar. But we figured since that could get really messy and weird, we'd do it when we were taping it for the ages. So if you're ready for us to walk the tightrope of two slides together... We're going to use the saddest song ever in the history of depression. Going back to December of 1968, I believe.
That was when I was born, right?
That's right. So y'all can sing along if you remember this one. Found another and gone away. With her when my future, my life is filled with gloom. So day after day, I stay locked up in my room. I know to you, well, it might sound strange, say y'all, well, I wish it would rain. Oh, how I wish that it would rain. Oh, cause so badly I want to go outside. Everyone knows that a man ain't supposed to cry. Listen, I got to cry, cause crying will ease my pain. To the world outside, my tears I refuse to explain, but I wish it would rain. I'll say it again. Oh, let it rain. There in there, I'm a tear-stained face, pressed against the window pane while my eyes search the skies desperately for rain. Cause raindrops will tide my teardrops and no one will ever know that I'm crying.
when I go outside to the world outside, my tears I refuse to explain, but I wish it would rain. I can hear you singing now. Oh, how I wish that it would rain. Say it again. Oh, how I wish that it would rain. Let it rain to disguise the tears in my eyes. Let it rain. Oh, let it rain. Oh, let it rain. Listen, I'm a man and I've got my pride. Till it rains, I'm gonna stay inside. And I wish it would rain. Oh, I wish it would rain. Come on, John. Till it rains, I'm gonna stay inside. Let it rain to disguise the tears in my eyes. Let it rain, sing it with us. Oh, how I wish that it would rain. Let me hear you. John Mooney, y'all. All right. Ooh, Temptations.
Yeah. You're a temptation, yes.
And y'all sound good, by the way. I hope you were singing along at home, too.
Do I see it in your eyes? Do you love me, baby? Or are you trying to say goodbye? Your love and arms, love and charms, got me sending my baby 5 feet long. But do you love me, baby? I'm in your eyes. love you right. As a man, baby, I'll get you every night. And you love me, baby, I ain't no sin in your eyes. Do you love me, baby? Oh, are you trying to say goodbye? Thank you. Hey, this next song is a thing, another song I wrote quite a while ago. Do we have time for another one more to business dinner? This little thing. This is on the, got a house party record coming out around Jazz Fest, and this is called Can I Live in a Glass House?
Don't.
Looking in your lips, my world drift away. Walking out the door and you finally got your way. Living in a glass house, still throwing stone. 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 Thank you,
John Mooney.
Thank you very much, and Marc Stone, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, you're right. And now, Miss Leslie.
There we go. I was gonna let that one roll. I like that. Oh, yeah, put your hands together one more time. Let's let everybody at home hear you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Oh, my goodness. This is, so I want you to take a look at the screen, and if you're in here in the house, you need to step back over there, because this is where we've got Frenchy painting the live event portrait of tonight. You go to the FunkyUncle.Live, and there's a click to donate, a click to watch, a click to become a sponsor like Faubourg Private Wealth has done for weeks and weeks and weeks, months and months, actually. Got to give it to them. Put your hands together for those folks that have been sponsoring us. But there's also a very important button, and it's click here to bid on the Frenchy painting. And if you will look, he creates it in, what, we've been here for less than an hour? And he's got an amazing painting going for you right there. So don't forget, click on that button and check it out, all right? Also,
and you can buy it for me for my birthday.
And you can buy it for Mark first. When is your birthday, Mark?
Saturday.
Saturday.
And we're going to have a party Friday night.
You might? Where's that party going to be?
At DBA.
But Mark,
don't tell the folks at Tips.
Party. And we'll all sing happy birthday to you and stick a pin in your chest, in your shirt. Shirt, yeah. All right, so don't forget, though, next week we're back here at Tipitina's for the Rumble with Chief Joseph Boudreaux Jr. And then the next week is our second anniversary show. This is really big. I'm going to go over it one more time. April 6th, Leo Nocentelli, George Porter, Mike Lemler, C.R. Groover, Josh Paxton, Tom Worrell, Funky Uncle All-Stars, Jason Neville, Lorette Neville. I think I got it. Oh, the running partner. George Porter and the running partners. I said George. Excuse me, running partners. They're going to hurt me when they see me. I know they will. That is going to be, I'm not going to say unfortunately, our last weekly webcast. Because fortunately, the Funky Uncle set
out to do something, and they have done it. In 104 weeks, raised over $644,852 musicians and gig workers help. I think we can take a break for a minute, but not for long. There's a lot going on. We've helped all of these folks. We've helped some of our bars, but there's somewhere else that I need you to help. And this is very, very important. Someone that has just as much of an important mission as we do here at the Funky Uncle, and that is to take care of our music community, and that is the New Orleans Musicians Clinic. On Sunday, March 27th, at the Maple Leaf, there's the Jamie Galloway, 8th annual Jamie Galloway Crawfish Boil Block Party. Dave Jordan, the Tanglers are going to be doing Talking Grass. We've got the Funky Uncle All-Stars. We've got a lot of people that are playing, and I don't want to miss any of them, so give me a second. Give me just a second. We've got the Riverbenders with members of the New Orleans Suspects, Honey Island Swamp Pan, and George Porter Jr. and the Running Partners. Proceeds are going to go to help the New Orleans Musicians Clinic, and you can buy your tables of crawfish. You don't have to go and sit and eat out of that little beer flat. You can go and buy a table. So check that out. Go to the Maple Leaf website and check that out.
I can attest to the fact that the Musicians Clinic is very important to keep it up and running.
Absolutely.
It's really good.
They've saved
all
my
of us
life.
Can attest to that.
They're going to save my knee on Monday. I tell you, they're going to work on that. So
yeah, I'm going next week, huh? Too.
Cured his baldness. We've got hecklers in the audience. We love having my hecklers here, darling. Thank you so much.
Was that Jay Heckler? Right.
A heckler? So anyway, do not forget all of these important dates. And I really, really, really want to see you April 6th because it's going to be an incredible show. It really, really is. So I need to ask you guys, can I get one? We're going to come back for an interview afterwards, but I sure would like to hear one more song. Can we do one more? You give me one more, and then we'll do the interview. Do not leave. Do not leave, because we're going to learn a lot of really, really good stuff here. I'm going to get all their deepest, darkest secrets. And in the meantime, you know what you got to do? Y'all say it with me. You got to wash your hands and stomp your feet.
Country boy, yeah, down in New Orleans, find a well, get them beans and greens, try it. Creole girl gon' turn my dapper down. Creole girl turn my dapper down. I'm making the country boy move out of town. Pretty hair got the great big beautiful eyes. Pretty hair great big beautiful eyes. They're making that country boy soon enough get wise. Cause I'm a country boy. Yeah, yeah, down in New Orleans. Thank you.
Marc Stone, John Mooney. Yes, indeed. All right, as promised, I told you we're going to sit down. We're going to do a quick little interview here. You got water? You good to go?
Yep.
You have a beverage?
I'll be right back.
You have a beverage? You'll be right back? Mark's going to be right back. He says he is. In the meantime, I'm going to tell you, don't forget. Now, don't leave. We got the interview. It's not going to be long. And you're going to want to hear all of this good stuff. So,
all the secrets of the trade.
The secrets. See, he's going to give a lot of secrets. Let's tell all the Marc Stone secrets before he gets back. You want to do that?
Well, those are secrets, though. Those are.
Yeah. Mr. John Mooney, what a pleasure it is to have you on the stage and for me to be able to sit this close and watch you play.
Thank you, Leslie.
Who are the people that you have enjoyed sitting this close to and watching play over the years? Who's your favorites?
Well, I started playing here at Tipitinas, like the first month, I think, that it opened is Tipitinas. Mm-hmm. And because we were playing at Ford's Place, which was a few blocks down the street.
At what?
Ford's Place,
okay.
Yeah, John Magney, Lee Harris, and I had a trio that we were doing down at Ford's. And then when Tips opened up, we came and started playing up here. So just about everybody who's ever played at Tipitina's, I've seen a lot of Professor Longhair, Toots Washington, Snooks Eaglin, everybody, I don't know, everybody.
So you can't say you've had a favorite.
Well, I don't know. Fess was probably one of my favorites, and Snooks.
Mm-hmm.
Earl King, of course, Mr. Yeah. Earl.
And all of these people, you didn't just get to sit and listen to. You actually got to play with them.
Yeah, we did a lot of opening shows, did a lot of playing with. And like Earl and I toured Japan together.
Mm-hmm.
And with the oh, like Johnny Vidakovich, Jimmy James, and John Cleary, and the Wild Shop, not the Shop Tour, it's the Wild, it was Bo Dallas and the Magnolias with
Monk Boudreau and Bo Dallas. Boudreau.
We went to France and different places in Europe together, all on the same bus, which was highly exciting.
And that's what we're calling it these days.
Yeah. Oh, and seeing like the Meters' last show back in the 70s, and before they quit for a while, and the Wild Chapatulas playing at Tipitinas, which was those were just wild days. You know, it was just great. You know, with the whole neutral ground would be packed with people and all inside, and I lived upstairs for about half a year. I mean, they didn't used to have the balcony, you know. It was all apartments, and I lived in the apartment, which was right up here.
Uh-huh.
And WWOZ was in the apartment down on that end of the
building. I was going to ask you, they were over in that corner over there?
Yeah, or actually they went right across, the two apartments right across. They went.
So you and Ernie Cato were roommates.
There were other apartments up there. We weren't roommates.
I heard that a story about one of the show hosts is on the air, and they hear a noise, and here comes Ernie wrapped in a towel on his head and his toothbrush in his hand. He had been sleeping in the studio. You know, he was between apartments at that time. Yeah. So now that Mark is out here, we're going to ask you, who do you enjoy playing with, John?
Well, Marc Stone is one
there
of my
go.
Favorites.
There
absolutely.
So, yeah. Mark, who are your favorites that you have played with on this stage?
On this stage, well, I mean, playing here with Mooney is pretty much one of the great experiences. Not just because of his history with the club, but because there's not many people in the world who play this kind of. We'll use acoustic in the broad term, meaning without drums, this kind of acoustic blues with this kind of fire and passion. So to be able to play here as a duo with John, which I guess is the third time we've gotten to do it. I got to play here with completely by accident a few years ago. I was down at DBA sitting in with Walter Wolfman Washington on the Wednesday between jazz fests, and I was packing up my guitar, and this guy was like, "Hey, that was kind of cool." I'm like, "Oh, thanks." We started talking. He said, "Oh, yeah, we're in town for the fest." I said, "Oh, your music, oh, we have a band, blah, blah." Next thing I know, it's like 2 a.m. the next morning, and I'm loading in to play with Leftover Salmon and Colonel Bruce Hampton for the Colonel's birthday party. 3 a.m. jazz fest show with Billy Payne from Little Feet on piano, and that was a pretty epic Tips experience. And the first time I played here in 1999 for Piano Night was amazing. I had to play with Tommy Ridgely. And most of you probably don't know who Irving Charles was, but he was one of the greatest and most important bass players in New Orleans history. And that night, I also got to play with Eddie Bowe, with George Porter and Johnny Vidakovich and Charlie Miller and Eric Traub. So those are some good Tip stories.
Some good ones. Some good ones. So you moved here in 76, right, John? And just fell right into it. And the number of songs on your set list, you must have to use a dolly to carry all of those songs. Why did how did you choose the tunes that you played here tonight?
Well, some of them, because they're going to be on the live album that we have coming out, that I have coming out. It's a house party I played at 2 years ago, or three years ago? I don't know. It was before the pandemic started, so... So it's a house party down in the French Quarters, and some of the songs are on that.
You recorded at the house party?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah,
wow.
Me and Uganda Roberts, the conga player who played with not only Professor Longhair and Dr. John and the Meters, and he played with everybody in town, Alfred. And anybody who plays congas in town probably learned from Uganda also. I think it's one of the last gigs Uganda did before he passed on. And so some of the songs came from that. Which
songs that you played tonight are on that album?
Well, Glass House and Barrel House Woman was one. And I can't tell you the truth. I can't remember all the names of the songs. That's why paper and pen come in really handy sometimes.
Now, when it comes to writing, writing tunes, what do you find to be your inspiration? What kicks off a tune in your head?
Oh, usually it's relationships, I guess. You know, I mean, obviously love or the lack of love, that has a lot to do with a lot of the songs. Like, well, one song I did, Do You Love Me, which is on the album, is, well, obvious, Do You Love Me? You know, so that has a lot to do with a lot of the songs.
Has a lot to do with
it. A lot of people write about love, you know, not having love, needing more love, liking love.
So Mark, I know you stayed pretty much in and down. You didn't do a whole lot of the house parties or porch parties, but how did pandemic affect you? Did you write a lot during the pandemic, Mark? I'll ask you first.
I did some writing and I did a lot of recording. We're doing the soft release for the new record on Friday at DBA as part of this big party with
for your birthday
with Mooney and Marilyn Barberan and Papa Molly and Reggie Scanlon and Sun Pie Barnes and so many other wonderful people. Everybody but Mooney was on the record. We tried to get something going, but you know, we're always juggling reality when you're in a situation like that and there's health concerns. When we first started recording, we would go into the studio in May of 2020 and just, I mean, after the studio had wiped everything down, we'd wipe everything down. We're all masked up and measuring distance and all that, but we still managed to get a lot of work done and ultimately finish the album. And, you know, so that was a big part of my pandemic.
How about you, John? What did how did COVID treat you?
It kind of forgot about me, I think. But last night, Mark's band, it's mostly the band that's on the record, right?
Fair amount.
Yeah, played down at DBA last night. I tell you what, that band is cranking. it's really a great band, and
Mark
has become like the probably the most popular band leader in town, and it's just the bands are just always great with all the people you get to come and play with them and stuff. It's just really good. So I know DBA Friday is going to be a good time. Yes.
Thank you, Mr. Moon Man.
So John, let me ask you this: how important do you feel that New Orleans music and the New Orleans music culture, all of it, not just the music, the culture bears, the Indians, the brass bands, all of it. How do you feel, how important is that in our music worldwide? How do you think that has influenced it?
Well, I think that it's having a lot more influence worldwide in the last 20, 30 years. You know, a lot of, in the mid-80s, Rounder Records started putting out a lot of Zydeco records. And there's, you know, and the Chavatoulas while Chavatoulas, they were instrumental in really getting, like, the Neville Brothers and many of those just kind of funk bands out there because they were real popular all across the country. And so it's you see it just, like, in Europe, anything New Orleans is just, like, sold out in Europe, you know. So it's had a really big effect on, you know, people just worldwide. Everybody knows why, because it's the greatest music in the world.
Yeah,
And now with OZ, that you can get OZ any place, it's just spreading like wildfire, you know.
You don't happen to know a couple of people that are on the air there, do you?
Do I happen to know a
couple of people? Mark and I are both on Tuesdays. I do traditional jazz on Tuesday morning, and he rolls in about 2 o'clock and does his blues set. And I think Tuesday is one of the best days on WWOZ. What do y'all think? Yeah,
you're right.
We do have to thank those folks for putting your music out there. That's not everywhere in the country can you get that. But now you can look at all of the Funky Uncles. You can go back into our archives and catch it. Mark, we had you in there last summer.
You had me in February of 2021, and that was kind of my coming back out show. I didn't play around much during the original height of the pandemic, and I was trying to lay low and do the right thing. And it took a while for me to be comfortable with the idea of coming back out and bringing a band with me and being responsible for that. And the first major show that I did coming back out was the Funky Uncle last February.
Yeah, I got
so
my
give
big...
give it up for the Funky Uncle, y'all.
Yeah. I remember getting my big hug from it. That's the first time we dared to hug, you know, if you, are you how are you doing? You're all right? Let's hug. Yeah, let's hug it out. So, and that's what Funky Uncle has done for all of us. It's given the entire music community a great big hug, and it's been so wonderful to be a part of it. And we are not done yet. We've got two more shows, and then there's going to be a lot of special events that are going to happen throughout the year to keep that funk fund going and keep supporting. There will always be hurricanes. There will always, unfortunately, we do need to send our love out to those who were affected by the tornadoes that we had last night. I will have to say that I've heard from almost all of our musicians that are in the St. Bernard, and everybody's good. New Orleans Musicians Clinic checked in on their people today, and right now everybody's good. I'm sure there's a lot of cleanup, and know that we're here and we love you, and we have got you back on that one, just like the Funky Uncle has been for the last 2 years. Mark, John, what you got?
I just want to remind everyone, you know, what the Funky Uncle has been doing is amazing. And there's so many organizations that have come to the aid of the music and cultural community. But at the end of the day, what's going to keep us going through all of these challenges is you, the fans, because the old mechanisms for making money, records don't, there's no such thing as selling records anymore, except maybe vinyl as a vanity piece. Really what's kept musicians going through all these changes and then the craziness of the pandemic is you, the fans, directly supporting musicians by buying tickets to shows, donating directly when musicians raise funds, buying whatever merch is out there, letting your friends know about music you love. So remember, without y'all, we ain't doing shit. So we love you and we appreciate you. And we thank you for the support. And we hope you keep supporting through whatever mechanisms are available. And even if there's not something amazing like this weekly Funky Uncle webcast, you, the fans, can still get out there and support all the musicians you love. So.
Absolutely. All right, guys, I need y'all to do me a favor. I need y'all to look into the cameras. And I need you to say one at a time, I need you to say, wash your hands and stomp your feet.
Where the camera's at? All right.
Right here.
Wash your hands and stomp your feet.
Oh, yeah. Yes.
Got to do it. And then wash your hands again and stomp your feet.
Do it three times. No.
Aren't your feet already clean?
All right, Mark, your turn.
Wash your hands and stomp your feet. And don't forget, wash your hands again and give people that flu season fist bump if you've been sneezing.
That new COVID handshake. Guys, thank you so much. Marc Stone, John Mooney, I'm Leslie Cooper. I will see you next week live from the Funky Uncle.
Feels good music. Thank y'all very much. We do appreciate it.